looking at 17.6, which is sex linkage, and we're looking at the homologous chromosomes once again. We've said that there are 23 pairs of chromosomes, and we number each pair. They're homologous, homo, because they're the same. So this is the first pair, and then the next pair, and the next pair, and eventually we get down to the 23rd pair. Now, everybody knows that the 23rd pair are the sex chromosomes, and they appear not like this, but in an X shape or a Y shape. And we all know from GCSE also that when you have, when your 23rd pair of homologous chromosomes is an X and an X, that you are female. And we all know that when your chromosomes are an X and a Y, you're a male. So just recapping on GCSE stuff, what we've got to look at is the type of gametes that these different combinations produce. So if we draw a Punnett square, as they're called, and to show that these are gametes, what we have to do, if we remember, is we're going to write female here, we're going to put an X, we're going to put it in a circle to show it's a gamete and a circle. And the male is going to be, he can only ever give an X or a Y chromosome. So it's the male that dictates the sex of the child. So if we look at the various combinations, we've got a female, we've got a female, we've got a male, and we've got a male. So we know that this is GCSE stuff, and we're just recapping on that. So we've looked at the convention of communicating various crosses, and we know that when we do a dominant, we use a capital letter, and when we're representing a recessive allele, we use a lowercase letter. We know that. That's just standard. Then we learned about codominance, where we looked at, there's no dominant or recessive, but the alleles are equally expressed. And that changes, that showed us that we always use something, for instance, like for blood groups, which the alleles A and B are codominant, we use a letter I and a superscript A. We use the letter I and a superscript B, and we use the letter I and the superscript O. And just recapping, what we've said is these two are codominant, and this is recessive to both. So, in example, we would say I, A, I, O has blood group A. If this is a B, they've got blood group B. And if this is a O, we've got blood group O. New convention we're looking at today, because we're looking at sex-linked inheritance. And what that actually means is any gene that is carried on the X or the Y chromosome is associated and is called X-linked disease. So if we have a look at it now, the convention is that when we draw the whole chromosome, so for example, if I've got something and I've got a capital H, that might represent haemophilia. I use the H next to the X to show that that is carried on the X chromosome, and on the Y, there might be nothing because the X chromosome is bigger. Imagine that this gene is carried here. On the Y chromosome, there's no corresponding part, and so it's unable to carry the allele for that particular gene. So when we talk about sex-linked inheritance, the famous case is that of haemophilia. Haemophilia is a disease of the blood. It's a genetic condition. And the famous family that carried this gene were the royal family in the UK. And we'll look at why. So if you have the normal haemophilia allele, you produce a protein that's involved in blood clotting. If you have the recessive allele for haemophilia, you don't have that you don't make that protein, and therefore your blood clotting processes are screwed. Basically, you can't clot your blood. So this one is dominant to this, and the way that we represent it is with an X and a H, and because again it's on this leg, the Y doesn't carry it, and an X and a H there. So when we look at who's going to get this inherited disease, it's mostly males. And males carry the disease, they suffer from the disease. And the reason why is because if you've got a female passing, she's got two X chromosomes, so even if she carries that allele, it is masked by the more dominant one, so she's still able to make protein. So this person will be a carrier, but she will not suffer from the disease. If, for instance, she marries somebody who doesn't have haemophilia, and he has X, and he has Y, and again, he's not a carrier, he doesn't have haemophilia, so when we put these into gametes to show that that's what they are, if this gamete combines with this one, they're going to have a normal female. If this gamete combines with this one, they're going to have a normal female, but she is a carrier for the disease. In this one, if we're going to have a boy born, then mum's going to pass on this one. Dad's not going to give anything to the situation, and they're going to have a normal boy because he's got the protein there. But if this gamete forms with this boy is going to have haemophilia. So if you look at any of the population, you're going to find that all boys have the disease that carry this particular allele, but you don't find women past a certain age. And that's because women can actually get the disease, but if they do, they are very, very, very unlucky, because it means that they've inherited that from mum and that from dad, which means that dad had the gene, because that's how it would have been expressed. But when a female gets to puberty and starts to menstruate, then the blood loss involved is enough to kill her. It can be lethal, and therefore she is going to die in the population, and that gene, that allele, is not going to be passed on.